I know you're trying to line up some interviews. Have you got that first interview lined up? All right, let's do that, and then after that, we'll go to a break. We are going to be interviewing Patrick Wilson. Patrick Wilson is known to many. You'll recognize his face when you see him, but he was in the movie Midway. We're going to talk to him about Midway, which is now available, Spectrum On Demand, and also home delivery. You got that lined up, Tim? All right, let's go to Patrick. Patrick?
Movies. Really appreciate you taking the time to talk about Midway today.
Sure, thank you. Good to talk to you.
I tell you, watching this film, there are so many layers to the characters and layers to the narratives. I really would love to hear why you feel it was important for audience to see these varied perspectives and viewpoints of this time and place in history.
Sure. Well, I think it's important for everybody to understand not only the context of the battle, how important this naval battle was, but also where it started, where it came from, why we got into the war, why the Japanese got into the war. And I think, you know, you can both be patriotic, extremely patriotic, and still a globalist and have a sense of how you fit into the world. So while this is an extremely proud American film, it's also really great to see the other side, which is something that the movie sets up very well, to understand the humanity that is both gained and lost in time of war. And I think that's it's always important to remember that, because if there's one message that always sinks out, that sticks out to me, it's that patriotism has nothing to do with politics whatsoever. And I think you have to deal with man-to-man, that understanding of looking into the eyes of your enemy. Only then, I think, do you understand what the cost of life is.
At what point, when this role came your way, at what point did you know this is what you wanted, and what was it about it that you said, yeah, I want to be a part of that?
Well, you know, I've had a lot of family that served. I've had a lot of friends that served. I didn't, and it's something for me, honestly, as a grown man, this is the way that I know how now, honestly.
Gotcha.
As a 46-year-old man, I can sit here and watch my friends and my family that have gone through this service and go, you know, that's not what I did. That's not the path I chose. So this is how I can repay them. I can be the most honorable, brave actor that I can to try to give some spark of courage and bravery that these men had. So I took it with great responsibility. And everyone in the cast did, to be quite honest with you, because you don't get chances like this a lot. And it's something that I think it shows a time when the country really united, and I think that's important.
I tell you, Patrick, really appreciate your time. Really appreciate what you presented in this film, Midway.
I think
it's something that that everyone should see. History is only going to be history if you don't embrace it and if you don't immerse yourself in it. So thanks for what you did, and thanks for taking the time to talk with us here on Meet Me in the Movies.
Sure, thank you.
They're gonna put me in the movies. They're gonna make a big star out of me.
Welcome back to Meet Me in the Movies. Appreciate you spending time with us right here. You can always email us, info@c19.tv, if you'd like, and if you don't, then that's fine as well. I know that during the break we did get the other satellite link set up with cast and director.
By the way, these are costing me a fortune, these satellite links. I want you to know, this is a big budget show. Really, you're busting it.
Thomas said he'd pay for the next ones.
If you pay me back with interest, of course, yeah.
It's all about interest for Thomas.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, we did interview Patrick Wilson from Midway right before the break, and now we've got director Roland Emmerich, Luke Kleintank, and also at screen, a couple of cast members from Midway. Tim, you got that ready for us? All right, here we go. Let's go to that interview.
Hi, Roland, Ed, and Luke. This is Noel Manning. Meet Me in the Movies. I hope you guys are doing well today.
Yes, we're doing great, man.
Thank you, sir. I hope you're doing well, too.
I am. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk about Midway. Roland, the first question, I want to send this out to you. You're definitely no stranger to films that are fueled with action and films that are based in history. I'd love to hear some of your thoughts about kind of the key differences in bringing a film like Midway to the big screen compared to what you offered audiences with The Patriot nearly two decades ago, both of those based in history, different types of history, but still history nonetheless.
Well, you know, this movie, you know, everything was real and authentic. So it's like kind of real historic characters. And that brings a whole set of, responsibility to you. You shoot like kind of a movie different than other movie because you have like historians on the set, you have military specialists for everything. And so what you want to do is like kind of be as correct as possible, because a lot of these men have still living families and you'll have to honor them.
Yeah, absolutely. And Ed and Luke, you know, kind of taking this to you, what are the takeaways that you would love audiences to see through the eyes of your characters because it is character-driven, this film?
Yeah, what I love about what Roland and Wes did with this movie, this screenplay, this narrative, is it's a balanced view. They're showing the horrors of war. You know, yes, we're talking about the Battle of Midway, which ultimately was a success in inverted commas, but success at what cost? You know, the cost of war, the horrors of war, the sadness that these young men went off to fight each other over the Pacific, and the loss of life, the tragic loss of life from both the Japanese and the American side.
In American history, this can never happen.
I think that's the main takeaway that we should, that I'd like modern audiences to take away. We're in a time of relative privilege and relative peace in America and Europe, and I think we have to remember the sacrifices that our grandparents' generation, the greatest generation, you know, that they gave for us, and the bravery that they showed, and in turn that should show us how lucky we are. You know, and we should fight to keep the peace and not make the same mistakes of the past and continue this human cyclical cycle of repeating the same mistakes. So I hope it gives people gratitude.
Yeah, I do too. You know, and it's amazing because film is such a wonderful medium for people to kind of come together. And I also think it's really important for the young generation to not to be naive to this battle. And so for them to be able to watch it, and for people of my generation to be able to see this in that kind of visceral way is going to be, it's an amazing experience. You're not going to be able, most of the time you read these things, you look at pictures, and we get to see true heroes, especially in a world where comic books are heroes, and these were real heroes. These are true men. They're not fiction, they're fact.
Well, I appreciate that. Roland, you know, for you to bring this story to life, what messages would you want audiences to make sure that they walk away from, much like what Ed and Luke shared about their characters?
Well, it's like kind of overall, it's this fact, you know, that these men, 80 years ago, risked their life for democracy so that we lived in a free world. We always like forget that, and especially younger people today should like have to be reminded of that, you know. And that's actually the main purpose of a movie like this, to show, they kind of fight, they fought and died for freedom.
Roland, Ed, Luke, thank you all so much for taking the time to talk about Midway right here on Meet Me in the Movies. Really appreciate you guys very much for bringing this film to life and bringing this story to life.
Thank you. Well, thank you, Matt.
I'd like to thank the director and the cast of Midway for spending time talking to us today. If you have not seen Midway, it is available now, Spectrum On Demand, and also for home delivery, Blu-ray, DVD, and other ways. Thomas?
VHS.
VHS. You could probably find a VHS copy of Midway, but it's the one from 1975 with Charlton Heston.
Yeah.
So Thomas.